So 750,000 Americans have died of COVID-19 now. And while you guys were overseas, the intel community said basically that they're stuck and can't figure out how it originated because Beijing continues to hinder the global investigation. So would President Biden punish China in some way for that?
Well, as you know, the ODNI, the COVID Origins Report, the president received that not too long ago. So I'll speak to that because that's the closest to what we have at the moment to talk to that. So this administration has been clear that it is imperative for the global scientific community to understand the genesis of the pandemic. Understanding the origins of COVID-19 remains a key focus for this administration and for all countries around the globe. The U.S. government, the intelligence community, and the academic and public health community will continue studying COVID-19's origins and how this pandemic spread as part of their ongoing work. So you're right, it's incredibly important for us to get to the bottom of this. But of course, to better understand the origins, some future studies must include additional access to data from China, as you are asking me about. Time is of the essence for access and analysis, and we and our partners will continue to press for transparency and answers from the PRC on key outstanding questions on the origins of the pandemic and its early days in China. For any additional details and assessments, we refer you to ODNI, but we're going to continue pressing so because we do have to get to the bottom of it.
Okay, thank you. And then President Biden is calling these reports about the administration paying up to $450,000 to illegal immigrants who are separated from family members garbage. He says it's not going to happen. But the ACLU says that it is. So who is right?
Wait, are you talking about the question you asked him yesterday?
Yes.
So if it saves taxpayer dollars and puts the disastrous history of the previous administration's use of zero tolerance and family separation behind us, the president is perfectly comfortable with the Department of Justice settling with the individuals and families who are currently in litigation with the U.S. government. You know, DOJ can obviously speak more to that process. The president was, what he was reacting to was the dollar figure that was mentioned, that you mentioned to him yesterday. As press accounts to date indicate, there's been press accounts on this, DOJ made clear to the plaintiffs that the reported figures are higher than anywhere that a settlement can land. Again, this is something that the Department of Justice can speak to. I do not have anything more to add to this.
But if he's not okay with $450,000, how much money is he okay giving?
This is something that the Department of Justice is going to handle. I just laid out what he was thinking and how this is the process was moving forward. The DOJ will talk to the specifics of this.
And so what changed then from yesterday? You're saying that he would be perfectly comfortable settling with these families who broke the law to come here, but yesterday he said that's not going to happen.
First of all, let's remember how we got here, how we got to a place where we're dealing with families being separated. This is coming from the last administration, cruel, inhuman, immoral policies against just people. It's separating children from their families, 18-month-olds, 2-year-olds, 5-year-olds from their families. That's how we got here, is because of the last administration. This is what we're trying to deal with here in this administration. So let's be very clear of how we got here and what's happening. Anything else that you would like to know about this, again, I'll send you to the Department of Justice. I can't speak to specifics, any more specifics on this.